be a good musician, you have to have your own voice. You have to be an original.
If you feel you have a need to be an artist, you should be able to get somewhere with that dream.
I was born in Glasgow, and I didn't start studying piano until I was 11. And that was with someone privately. And then she recommended that I go to the Royal Scottish National Academy. And then the Glasgow authorities gave me a scholarship to go and study in London.
So I started out by singing on the stage between the movies. My sister was a singer and pianist, so we had a routine called Pat Mike. I had to learn a fiddle for the act. So anyway, that's how I got into the violin business. So then I went straight and had proper lessons. Eventually, I went to New York and studied with a great teacher there. And that's when I felt for sure I was a violinist now. And then right after that, I went to London, where I met Isobel, as you know.
I don't remember when we started to play together, but we did, not long after that. He decided to go back to Canada, and I was staying in London, and then he asked me to go out there to Vancouver.
By the time I was 26, I had a pretty big background. The time came for me to come back to Canada, so they said, why don't you come to Edmonton and take over the direction of the Edmonton Symphony and be a professor at the university and make something happen.
I was a harpist for some time with the Edmonton Symphony. I'd never played the harp, but when I came to Edmonton, there was no harpist in the community, and then I learned it. The government of Alberta, who had an education program, and they asked us to come to Banff and teach, and we were teaching in the elementary school.
At first, when I taught here, there were no additions, and there were a lot of young children.
Then it changed, it grew, and it became very international. In 1979, Peter Lougheed had the wisdom to give the Banff Centre support to be a year-round institution.
Well, we spent every summer there from the age, well, since I can remember. So when we actually moved there, it wasn't this huge, big deal.
They've had a huge impact on this particular institution, taking it really from a part-time little summer school that dealt really with sort of high school age kids to a major international institution that deals with people from all over the world.
I think they were able to attract extraordinary faculty. And if you have a faculty like they had in the music department, with all the great cellos, the composers, the conductors, you name it, then that is a big draw.
We invite many visitors to interact with them and give them career advice.
The most miraculous thing here is the interaction of artists.
The highest form of music making is in collaboration with other artists, and this is something that Tom and Isobel really encourage.
You learn a lot every time you meet a new visiting artist.
Collaboration with other musicians is probably the biggest thing that I've gained here.
What we tried to do with each person was to provide them with all the tools so they could learn themselves, because their best teacher, of course, is yourself.
You get here, and within a day, you realize that they accept you as a fellow artist and that they have this confidence that you have something to say with your art form.
There were no courses that everyone had to do. You come with your own project, and it can be preparing for an international competition, an orchestral edition, composing, a commission, all of these things.
We've got a good scholarship program. We've got food, we've got peace and quiet.
But each musician who comes has their own studio for 24 hours a day. And that's so unusual. But we're lucky because the Banff Centre has this facility.
You learn so much from being here. You have so much time to go into stuff that you don't have time to go into when you're in your everyday life.
I think the fact that you are insulated and free of duties at Banff is very helpful.
Everyone's so keen to play music here, and everyone's really focused on what they're doing.
And we have sometimes 5 to 8 concerts a week. A week! We can't believe it.
The concerts, of course, are constant. That's the other focus that they have. Perform, perform, perform.
You learn to perform and feel confident at stage by doing it again and again and again.
And the concerts here, just hearing other people playing concerts, you just can, even if it's a different instrument or a different style of music, you say, well, what made that incredible?
They come to every concert and they listen to every musician with so much attention and an open mind.
I love the fact that they are very involved and very aware of absolutely every individual that is at the program.
People feel that they can come here and try things which are unusual, that are creative, and that they will be supported.
Most young people think that there's a right way and a wrong way. There's all kinds of different ways of playing. And people come here to be free.
And my parents created this sense of everything and anything is possible.
Their whole focus is the life of these young artists.
They, in a very gentle way, get you to expand your horizons or your ideas of what kind of an artist you are.
They devoted every inch of their lives to making this thing work and to pretty much the betterment of all the people who come here.
As you might hear from most of the people that have been through this place, that first of all, somebody cared about them.
They're always so supportive, so encouraging, and they're also very loyal people.
The musicians, as a result, are just completely inspired. Everything is okay all of a sudden.
It changes you as a musician and as a person.
A very quiet, small revolution has centered around our work.
Everything is a gift, you know, life, the way they look at this world, the way they believe in people, what they give to people, I mean, it's all about that. So it was interesting that from a very young age, that whole notion of music and art and the experience of it and the learning and creativity involved with it is a gift.
They're just the most fabulous people I've ever met.
They're like little magic people. I don't know how else to describe it.
They're gardeners of musical souls.
They make you feel very, very good about yourself and about your time there. They're not only are they awesome musicians, they're great mentors.
Their good humor, their charm, their graciousness, and their ability to dream and to help others realize theirs.
They truly believe in human beings and the creative potential and the creative expression.
Reward for us too. So I'm very happy about it.
And it's a hell of a life out there for a lot of people in the arts. And they need to know there's something and some people that care about them. And everybody knows that. We never abandon them as long as we exist.